This one really blew my mind. Imagine you get an Excel file from your colleague, you open it, and then you realize it has a lot of external blanks. You want to check exactly what these are and if they're still valid or not. Now, one option is to go to the Data tab, click on Edit Links, and check the location of each link one by one. Or you get the full list of links by typing in this formula. If you want it vertical, just put it inside the transpose function. Crazy, right? That's what I thought when I received Bob's message. He combined the past with the future. Dynamic arrays with Excel 4.0 macros. When I asked him about it, he sent me this email. Now, in case you're wondering, the content of the email wasn't deleted. That's the whole email. It's what I like about Bob. Who needs the content box? Long story short, I checked page 92 of his book right here. Let me show you what I found. Now, these old style Excel for macros are still around. And if you take a look at the Microsoft support page, it says Excel still supports them, but they encourage you to migrate to VBA. What we're going to do instead is to combine them together with dynamic arrays. I'm going to show you two practical examples. Number one is to get the list of all the external links that are used in this workbook. And in the second example, we're going to get a list of all the file names that are sitting in a specific directory. Let's start with links. In this sample workbook, I have external links, and I can see that because the moment I opened it, I got this security warning that automatic update of links has been disabled. Now, if you take a closer look in the Data tab, for example, I'm referencing a cell that's sitting in a file on my desktop. In the Budget tab here, I'm referencing some other file. My aim is to get the list of all these workbooks on this sheet right here. To be able to use these Excel 4.0 macros, we first have to create a name for them. To do that, go to the Formulas tab and click on Name Manager. Then click on New. Here we can give our function a name. So in this case, I'm going to call mine getLinks. Under Refers to here, we need to reference that Excel 4.0 macro, which is called links. So type in equals links, open bracket, close bracket, and then click on OK. And then let's just close this. Now, all we have to do is to type in the name we gave it, which was get links. I can see it down here, and press enter. I get a spilled range of all the external links. Now, the reason I got a spilled range is because I have the latest version of Excel in the Insider Edition, which means I have Excel's new calculation engine. So I have dynamic arrays. That's why I don't need to wrap this inside another formula like the index formula. Now, if I wanted this vertically, which would be easier to read, all I have to do is put this inside the transpose function. And this is the complete list of external links that are used in this workbook. This way, I can always double check that my formulas are referencing the correct workbook. Now, what happens if we add a new external link? So I have another workbook opened that's already saved on my desktop. It's called Book 1. Let's just input a number and copy it. Go back to our existing workbook, and I'm going to paste it as a link. So go to Paste Special and click on Paste Link. Now, the moment I pasted this, this didn't update. For this list to get updated, I need to force calculation. Ctrl-Alt-F9. The moment I do that, the link is updated here. Now, let's take a look at our second example. Let's get a list of file names in a specific directory. Again, I need to create a name for that function. So I'm going to go to Name Manager, click on New. The name I'm going to give this one is Get Files. And for Refers to, type in equals files and open bracket. Now, because I want to reference to a specific folder, I'm going to reference B3. That's where I have the folder path. Now, close bracket, click on OK, and close. If I just start to type in equals get files, and I press enter, it's not going to work. For it to be able to give me the list of all the file names that are in this directory, I need to work with wildcards. So I have to add the backslash here and then use the wildcard character, which is the asterisk sign. Once I do that, I get the list of the files spilled horizontally. To get them spilled vertically, I'm going to put them in the transpose function. And that's the list of all the files. I have Word files in there, I have macro enabled files, and I have normal Excel files. This also helps me to keep an eye on a specific folder. So let's say I'm waiting for my colleague to add the latest data. I refresh this before I go to lunch, so Control-Alt-F9. It's not there yet. I go for lunch, I come back, I refresh again, so Control-Alt-F9, and latest data is there. Now, what if I wanted to get this sorted? All I have to do is put my formula inside the new dynamic array sort function. So close bracket, press enter. I have the sorted list of my files. Now, what if I wanted to restrict this to only Excel files? I just need to update my path here by adding the extension that I want. So Excel SX, press enter, and that's my new list. Just don't forget that these are still macros. So if you want to save this file and keep the new functionality, you need to save it as an XLSM file. Okay, so that's how you can use Excel 4.0 macros together with dynamic arrays. I hope you like Bob's new discovery just as much as I did. That's what I love about Excel. There's always something new to learn for all of us. If you agree, hit that thumbs up. And if you aren't subscribed to this channel, consider subscribing.